Do subscribe to IKIDA channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Pigments. What are pigments basically? Substances that have an ability to absorb sun's energy in the form of photons at a particular wavelength are called as pigments. For example, chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, carotenoids, xanthophyll, this all are photosynthetic pigments. And these photosynthetic pigments are present inside grana. Remember the structure of chloroplast? Inside grana, there were certain pigments, and these are those photosynthetic pigments. Now, among all the photosynthetic pigments, chlorophyll A is the most important one. This is blue-green in color and the most important pigment. Chlorophyll A shows the absorption of energy at maximum wavelength, or it absorbs more amount of sunlight. It absorbs in the range of blue to violet. Remember physics, Vibgyor, the spectrum which absorbs light. So chlorophyll A absorbs in blue to violet range. Next, now chlorophyll A is the main energy molecule, or you can say main accessory pigment or main chlorophyll pigment. Now, apart from chlorophyll A, there are certain pigments present which are called as accessory molecules. When I say accessory, it means something which is not important. I mean, which is, if it is there, good. If it is not there, still it will have no hard and fast rule to be present. Accessory molecules of photosynthesis are chlorophyll B, carotenoids and xanthophyll. Now, chlorophyll B, this absorbs in the range of yellow to green color, in that Vibgyor spectrum. Xanthophyll absorbs in the range of yellow, whereas carotenoids absorb in the range of orange to yellow. Now, if these accessory pigments are not present, will it affect photosynthesis? Probably no. But if they are present, the photosynthesis rate is enhanced, or it is better. Apart from helping in photosynthesis, what are the other function of this accessory pigments or additional pigments? They protect the structure of chloroplast or chlorophyll. Basically, they assist chlorophyll A, as well as they protect the photosynthetic pigments and the structure of chlorophyll A. Pigments involved in photosynthesis. Pigments are substances that have an ability to absorb light. When I say light, it means sun's energy in the form of photons. That is, starts from the range of 460 nanometers. Photosynthesis never use UV range. It always use visible range. At a specific wavelength, which is 460, and the photosynthetic pigments are chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, carotenoids, and xanthophyll. Chlorophyll A, the most important pigment during photosynthesis. This is the most important pigment. It shows maximum absorption. When I say maximum absorption, it amounts the most amount of photons or sun's energy in the range of blue to violet, in the Vibgyor range basically. Accessory pigments are basically chlorophyll B, carotenoids and xanthophyll, and they enable photosynthesis to occur in other regions of the spectrum. Basically, they help during dark photosynthesis in some times. Now chlorophyll B, which is an accessory pigment, absorbs in yellow and green region of the spectrum, whereas xanthophyll absorbs in the yellow region of the spectrum. Carotenoids absorb in the orange to yellow region of the spectrum. So maximum amount absorption is by chlorophyll A, or the master pigment. Apart from helping in the process of photosynthesis, this accessory pigments also protect chlorophyll A from photooxidation. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about the various pigments of photosynthesis, that is chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, carotenoids and xanthophyll, and how they help each other to carry out the process of photosynthesis. I hope you all are clear about the concept of photosynthetic pigments. Thank you.